G'day, boys and girls. Mike here, aka Mike, aka Beast Like 2, and today I've got some domination for you guys. Wicked shotgun game that I got for the piss and went down, and look, it's pretty crazy.
A lot of dolphin diving, a lot of busting caps in people's asses, you know, jumping around, no one knows what's going on. It's the beast, baby. You mess with the beast, you get the horns. yeah, that was a bit gay, but got a few things to go through this video. I hope you guys are all excited, because I know I am. CJ4M just hit 1,000 subscribers. Oh my god! I know, it's awesome. I hope you guys are excited. I know I'm recording this commentary actually. We're at 1,106 subscribers. I think that's pretty awesome. And we love our subscribers. We love our subscribers so much. Whenever someone asks me, you know, Mike, who would you turn gay for, mate?
My answer is always
my subscribers. That's right. And if you happen to be a girl subscriber, I know there's one or two. If I had a vagina, I would also turn gay for you. So don't feel like that. a couple of people have been asking, you know, in comments, what it was like, what our first kiss was like. And if you haven't seen our last dual commentary, go watch it, because you will learn many things. You will thoroughly enjoy yourself, and you may even get an erection if you do indeed have a penis. I just want to point out that in Australia, you are only gay if you put your penis inside another man's bum, or vice versa. So, yeah, I pretty much just want to clear up that we are not gay. Seeing as this is a solo commentary, I want to talk a bit about myself. There's no Chris distracting me here, so we might actually get something done. Haha, no jokes. Love you, Chris. Pretty much, I started playing games when I was a little tacker, like, but, 5-6 years old. We got a Sega Mega Drive for Christmas. And get this, Santa wrote on the note that came with the Sega Mega Drive that some kid got a new Nintendo 64 for Christmas, and then we got his old bloody Sega Mega Drive. What a douchebag! Why the hell would he say that? I can't believe you, Santa. Good trade. That red bloody hat. It's blood! Isn't it? But if Santa, you do watch this video, please comment, because I'm sure everybody, all the subscribers, would love to hear what you have to say for yourself. No, I'm just kidding, I love Santa, he's brought me so many happy memories, and I want to thank him for the Sega Mega Drive. Next, we eventually, Mum won, you know, like those crossword things, and you send them in, and you win some stuff. Mum won a Nintendo 64 with Star Wars Pod Racer, and that was such a hard game. When I was like, I don't know, whatever I was, 8 years old or something like that. Tangent Abacus and Jabba were the only things that saved me from the wrath of Podracer. If you've ever played that game as a kid, and you play, what's the track? It's Abyss. And it is so hard. The CPUs go like triple the speed of you. If you fall down the bottom of those like walkway things, then you're absolutely stuck. And oh my god, did you see that double dolphin diving, crazy, insane, slow motion madness? That is what we teach you at CJ4M, that dolphin diving is surviving. This is madness! No, this is dolphin diving! I just fly kicked the wall. I should have seen that. Anyway, where was I? Probably the greatest game I've ever played is Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. That game is just a legend, and if you grew up with that game, you will know exactly what I mean. It was just the best game to play as a kid. So many memories of just doing the three spiritual stone temples or whatever they were over and over again, because I couldn't get past the water temple. I was stuck in the water temple for about 6 months, and then eventually I got up to the shadow temple. And I was stuck on that for about 4 years. I stopped playing it for ages. Only recently actually completed that game. Bomber Tube Bowling, I think, is still my favourite sport. I bet if you've never played these games that I'm talking about, this must sound just completely ridiculous. Why would you buy them, Beast Like 2? It's the awesome sport where you bowl a Bombachu, which is a bomb that runs around on little wheels, and you... What do you blow up? What do you blow up? I don't remember what you blow up, I just remember it was the funnest thing ever. And just chilling in Clock Town or whatever it was just a Friday afternoon for me, you know? No drugs or anything back in those days, we just Bombachu bowled. And that's how we entertain ourselves. Maybe the new generation of kids should take a lesson from that. Stop noob tubing. And just bowl Bombachu. That's all I have to say to you. Just on the subject of childhood, I was on the train the other day, right, and I got thinking about Looney Tunes. And specifically the Roadrunner versus Wile E. Coyote Looney Tune. And that is obviously everybody's favourite Looney Tune. I don't know why they're not bringing out more. I mean, they obviously sold a lot. What are Warner Brothers doing? Making the next Call of Duty? What's going on there? Anyway, they portray Wile E. Coyote as the bad guy. You know? He's trying to kill the Roadrunner, you know? He's using all these disgusting and ridiculously outrageous, sinister ways of killing the Roadrunner. I think they've got it all wrong. The Roadrunner is just running away. He spent his whole life running away from his problems. And, well, what's that teaching the kid? I mean, he's running away, and also he pays no respect. He sits there and eats the birdseed that's a trap, right? And he just humiliates Wile E. Coyote, letting him fall off cliffs and stuff. Like, what's that teaching the kids about respecting your enemy? And in the meantime, Wile E. Coyote, he gets up every single day and he thinks of new, innovative ways to kill just to get his food. I mean, he's got to feed the little coyote, doesn't he? He's got to get food and water for him. He's spending all this money at Acme, who charge ridiculous prices on, you know, rockets, slingshots, birdseed traps, trucks that come trying to run him over, and at the end of the day, he doesn't bring home the food. Isn't that the sort of determination that we should be teaching our kids? Not to run away? Come on, Warner Brothers.
Oh, wow, I couldn't give it straight face to you.
No, but what do you guys think about that? Do you think it's a reasonable view on the situation? Post in the comments what you think. And if you think they should change it, should they tweak it, put subtitles in saying, you know, Wile E. Coyote is good. Another announcement, we have made a Twitter, so now the PSN's back up, we're going to be doing a few open lobbies every now and then, or just, you know, if you want someone in our party, we're just like, yo, subscribe us, what are you doing, we want me in our party?
Our spy plane's in the air.
I don't know what that accent was, but yeah, if you want to play a few games with us on PlayStation, preferably if you're in Australia, that'd be great. Twitter link will be in the description, so make sure you follow us and keep up to date with all the CGM Forum news. I guess that's the end of the video. Check this hate message that some dude sent to me. Pretty funny. I'm Beast Like 2. Please rate and subscribe. Catch you later, alligator.